studying, working full time, doing pretty much everything a single girl would be doing at that time. I found out on a Friday night, and I should have been out having a good time with my friends. And my whole family was actually in there at the time, and the doctor came in and said, you know, I'm really sorry, but you know, we found like certain tumours in your body. That night after everyone had left, it was sort of, you know, wandering in the hospital, just thinking, like, am I going to die? Like, is it just, is that it? Or what's going to happen? It was just, yeah, really surreal. Enjoyed your life when it's being used for things. So I guess normalise your experience in hospital rather than feeling like you are in, you know, isolated in thoughts. I think that's important. Because when you're stuck in hospital, obviously it's not fun.
A bit over a year ago, my dad was diagnosed with a T-cell lymphoma, which was related to having celiac disease. And it was a quite aggressive cancer, and they did warn us that from the beginning. From diagnosis to his passing was only about 3.5 months. It was very difficult because he was a patient on my ward where I worked, and sometimes knowing a bit more than the average family member isn't always a good thing. I was getting married in a year from when his diagnosis, so of course my first thought was, is he going to be around for my wedding? You know, I mean, you want your dad there always, but you especially want them there for your wedding day. I remember him sitting in his room and he couldn't get coverage on his phone. And he didn't have a laptop, and at that point I didn't have a laptop either. So I think if he had had a laptop in the room with him, he could have at least emailed people and he could have at least looked up things. And
maybe that's definitely an issue. It's very expensive.
When you're in a hospital and you're a patient, you're not working. A lot of patients don't have work income protection and they're struggling, and then they have to pay $9 a day for TV.
Yeah, it's really good. It's really humbling because I know how hard it is for people to give up a drink. And you know, before I got sick, that would have been an effort for myself as well. Yeah,